he collected, contacted and collected 35 famous doctors with their families, daughters, wives, and he established the hospital the following way. He, as he told us, he stepped off as a youth leader, and he wasn't anymore a Nazi member. Since the war started, he changed his mind, but nobody knew about it. So he took out his old uniform and went to the Ministry of the Interior, or whatever you call it, and asked for the minister. And the minister accepted him. He didn't know that he resigned 4 years earlier. And he told him the story that the Russians are very close and there will be lots of wounded people, and the present hospitals won't be able to cope with all the situation. So he decided to contact doctors, professors, and he wants to establish a hospital. And the minister was very agreeable, and he asked his secretary to type out a letter and give it to Ara, and he has got the power to requisition anything and everything what he needed for the hospital, even a van to deliver everything to the hospital.
So it was a bold and brilliant plan.
It was. Yeah. It was. So it was incredible. And signed, sealed, delivered. He got the letter and he started to walk around in the ministry and stole quite a lot of ministerial letterheads and stamps. He was extremely shrewd and a very, very, very good organizer. So the next day we moved in. On the first floor there was a huge apartment where a very famous, at the time, very famous psychiatrist lived, and he asked him whether he would agree that he and his wife will live there and I will have one of the small rooms as an office. The psychiatrist agreed gladly, and slowly he got all together, everything. He took my husband with him every day for a few days, and he requisitioned, you name it, food, tin food, everything, and whatever he needed for the hospital. The hospital took place in the basement because there was a very large Bohemian retail shop, a huge shop with very expensive things in the shop, but underneath was a huge storeroom, and that was perfect for his intending hospital in the bunker. And storeroom, no more storeroom, everything was put aside, and he arranged the hospital downstairs in the bunker with my husband. 2 days later, a couple arrived, and they were told by my aunt, mother, that there we are, and it became came out that they were together in the Russian front at different labor camps, and they heard what happened, so they started to beg Ara, please. One of them went down to his knees, please take us, me and my brother and the two wives, and we will be very useful to you. So my husband told him, listen, they are very tough guys. If you want my advice, Ara, take them. So 2 hours later, the two couples moved in, and my husband and his two friends, one of them was Paul and the other one basically they were went out everywhere with Ara, and they were known as the three musketeers, the two brothers and my husband, food supplies, everything. So and the hospital started. The Russians were already closed, not to mention that we had bombardment from English and American bombers, so there was no problem with that. The 2nd of January, we woke up very early hour in the dawn, banging on the gates. Hungarian Nazis surrounded the place and came in loudly, saying that everybody down the courtyard with blanket and food for 24 hours. In a few minutes' time, we were all downstairs. It was extremely cold winter, and Ara came down in full uniform with the emblem, with the Nazi armband and revolver and everything. And he said there must be a mistake, and some of the Nazis told him, listen, we've heard that there are Jews in this house. No, there must be a mistake, it's a legal hospital, here is the Minister of the Interior. We are not interested. Okay, then, I will have to tell you, don't touch anybody. I'm going to see the minister myself now. I will be back. Until I will be back, nobody, but nobody should be hurt, and we will stay here. All right, guard them, but don't hurt them. They are not Jews. So he left, and a few hours later, he came back with another paper that it's a legal hospital, and the minister's signature, which was, as I found later on, he told only my husband a few days later that he couldn't find the minister. He was already either in hiding or was asleep or whatever. In the ministry there was a chaos. Nobody knew where the minister was. Nobody knew anything. The Russians are in the vicinity of Budapest. So there was complete chaos. So what he did, he sat down, he took away one of the letterheads, and he forged the minister's signature on it. He had his stamps, what he stole before, so there was no problem. He wrote another letter and came back and showed it to these charming, decent guys, and they left, they saluted, and they apologized. So we were safe. We knew that there was only one solution for us. They couldn't take us in any concentration camp by then, because Budapest was surrounded with the Russians. There was only one way, as it happened every day, that they shoot Jewish people into the Danube. The Danube was at that time rather red than blue, with bluish, Jewish blood. We were safe. So the hospital was in full work day and night. Everybody was working, daughters, wives, assisting, nurses, doing everything.